Bizarre flames spring up without warning, consume their victims, and ignite a firestorm of controversy. George Mott, engulfed in an inferno, while just feet away, his television barely melts. Mary Hardy Reeser, turned to cinder except for her foot. Helen Conway, consumed and reduced to ashes in just 21 minutes. And Beatrice Oski, burned to death while nothing nearby, including her cotton socks, catches fire. Are they victims of spontaneous human combustion? Or is there a scientific explanation for what killed them? These aren't isolated cases. Hundreds of incidents have been recorded all the way back to the 1700s. In the 1800s, social reformers blamed a much maligned malady, demon rum. They saw a connection between alcohol and these fires.
The idea was that maybe their body tissues just became so saturated with alcohol that their flammability was heightened. And you can see how in the middle of the 19th century, that could have seemed almost to make scientific sense. It's utter scientific nonsense, actually.
If it's not alcohol, is there another chemical chain reaction that could trigger the fires? Larry Arnold points out that skeptics and scientists are unwilling to consider what seems obvious to him. Spontaneous human combustion.
Mainstream science has no problem with spontaneous combustion, but when you inject human between spontaneous and combustion, you unleash a firestorm of derision, denial, and ridicule.
For spontaneous combustion to occur in humans, it would have to start inside the body and radiate outward. Arnold has an unorthodox theory on how this happens. He believes a still-to-be-discovered subatomic particle he calls a pyrotron strikes another subatomic particle inside the body. The collision triggers what amounts to a runaway nuclear explosion. Once this reaction takes off, it blazes out of control and burns the body from the inside out.
It's a theory. We can't prove it, but it's worthy of consideration in this larger mystery that history presents to us as spontaneous human combustion.
This is not something known to science, so you could call it X-force or X-factor. It's a pseudo-explanation. It doesn't explain anything.
The chemistry of human fat is not supportive of the kind of chemical reactions that have to go on for self-heating to occur. So the theory that this is a chemical reaction within the body producing an unusual amount of heat just doesn't work.
DeHaan believes in a much more established theory based on scientific principles.
Well, even good fire investigators, you know, will look at a fire and go, this is really strange. Well, yeah, it might be strange, but there's always an explanation, a scientific explanation.
DeHaan believes that cases of spontaneous human combustion are really caused by what he calls the wick effect. In the wick effect, a thick layer of fat under our skin provides the fuel. Once a fire heats it up, fat starts to liquefy. After the skin splits open, the fat is drawn from the body by clothes or other flammable material.
What happens is that as the fire chars the surrounding material, that charred material acts as a wick, and the body fat renders down, is absorbed into that wick material, and that's what actually supports the combustion of the body.
When heated, subcutaneous fat burns almost as well as diesel fuel or candle tallow.
I can get a lot of heat out of every gram of subcutaneous body fat.
So you're getting not a quick burnover like in a lot of cases of fire, but you're getting the body's almost feeding on itself.